Welcome. Here's a preview of what you'll do and learn in this walkthrough. You'll start off by creating a use case folder named Space Research and uploading the zipped folder we provide, which has 7 PDFs from NASA inside. In the graphical user interface, you'll create 2 different vector databases, followed by 1 playground. In the playground, you'll define 3 LLM blueprints using any combination of foundational LLM, LLM parameters, vector database, and system prompt. Here, you're seeing 3 LLM blueprints, all generating a 1-paragraph conference pitch based on a user-provided talk title, such as monitoring astronaut health status and applications of ISS science results on Earth. For each generated answer, you can inspect detailed citations and trace each text chunk back to which PDF and which page it came from. Next, you'll upload the evaluation dataset provided and produce aggregate metrics, such as average cost, average latency, or average Rougeon confidence score on the standard test set. Finally, you'll examine the trace table, which has been recording all interactions with the LLM blueprints for governance purposes. When you complete this walkthrough, you'll have built an end-to-end retrieval augmented generation pipeline with built-in evaluation, assessment, and logging. From the homepage, select a workbench and then create a new use case. Name your use case Space Research. Select Add Data, then Upload, and upload the zip file named Space Station Research without unzipping it. DataRobot will advance automatically to this screen, and you'll have a short wait while the dataset registers. You can use this time to look at the documents that are inside the zip file. You'll see that it contains PDFs sharing highlights from the International Space Station's research programs from the last couple years. Once the dataset is registered, choose Vector Database and then Create Vector Database. Select the zip file as the data source. Then select an embedding model. We'll go ahead and start with the recommended GINA embeddings. Move the chunk overlap slider to about 20% and leave max tokens per chunk on the recommended value of 256. Then give your vector database a descriptive name. I'm going to call it GINA 25620 to reflect my settings. Accept the other defaults and hit Create Vector Database. While this one is building, let's configure another one. Select Add Vector Database. Same zip file and different embedding model. Same chunk overlap, same token size to keep things apples to apples. Provide a descriptive name and create vector database. This will give us 2 options that differ in their embedding model but otherwise share the same settings. You can create as many vector databases as you like by iterating through this process. The best settings will depend on the type of text that you're working with and your use case. Advance to the Playgrounds tab and select Add Playground. In the playground, we can build, compare, and evaluate different LLM blueprints, but first we need to create the first one. Select Create LLM Blueprint. And then focus on the configuration panel here on the right. Select an LLM from the drop-down list. Note that you can also add your own. I'm going to reduce the temperature to focus on truthfulness for my scientific research papers. From the vector database options, I'll select the first one I created using GINA. And in prompting, I'll choose no context, and then I'll enter the following system prompt. Your job is to help scientists write compelling pitches to have their talks accepted by conference organizers. You'll be given a proposed title for a presentation. Use details from the documents provided to write a 1-paragraph persuasive pitch for the presentation. That's the end of the configuration, so let's go ahead and save that one. Let's test it out.
The International Space Station does some really fascinating research, and we've provided a list of suggested prompts to get you started. Let's ask for a conference pitch on blood flow and circulation in space. That looks pretty good. Let's try another title, such as Microgravity is Weird. That looks good too. I would definitely want to go to these talks. From LLM Blueprint Actions, let's edit this blueprint to give it a more descriptive name. And we'll save that. There's a couple ways to start comparing this to other outputs. From the comparison area, we can keep creating more LLM blueprints. From the three dots, you can also choose an existing one and copy it to a new blueprint. This allows you to easily change just one thing at a time. Keeping all of the previous settings the same, let's change only the vector database. I'll save that configuration, and I'll edit the name. I'll go back to compare, make one more copy, and this time I'll choose a different LLM. I'll double check my other settings, and I'll save that configuration. Don't forget to edit the name. We can give this LLM blueprint the same task that we gave the previous one. Write me a persuasive presentation pitch for Microgravity is Weird. It would be a lot of screen switching to do this one at a time, so let's go back to the comparison mode and put all three of these side by side. Let's give them a new topic, such as monitoring astronaut health status. And we'll also ask about applications of the space station's science results back here on Earth. I think you're getting the gist of how this works.
Which of these responses you prefer is subjective and depends on the use case, but there are some quantitative metrics to help you evaluate. This response took 9 seconds, had 131 tokens, and scored 92% on the Rouge 1 confidence metric. This metric will make more sense when you look at the citations. The generated answer from the LLM is based on a chunk from page 7 of the 2022 report, page 10 of the 2020 report, page 7 of the 2018 report, and so on and so forth. The Rouge 1 metric represents how similar this LLM answer is to the citations provided to aid in its generation. It's helpful to scroll and read a few of the citations. This is where you can see the impact of your chunk size selection back when you created the vector database. You may get better results with longer or shorter chunks. These metrics correspond to one LLM blueprint response. Similarly, these four metrics correspond to this other response. To evaluate which LLM blueprint is best overall, you will want aggregated metrics, such as the average latency, which would be 9.5 seconds, and the average Rouge 1, which would be somewhere in the 80s. That's the purpose of aggregated metrics. To calculate aggregated metrics, DataRobot requires an evaluation dataset. Provide the evaluation dataset by selecting the icon labeled LLM Evaluation in the upper left. Select Evaluation Datasets and then Configure. Look for the tile that says Evaluation Dataset Metrics and click it. With Upload Evaluation Dataset highlighted, click Select Dataset and upload the CSV file named Space Research Evaluation Prompts. It contains some additional conference titles to be used as a standard reference set. Once it's registered, proceed to select it. Fill in these two text fields with Question and Answer. You would only know this if you opened the CSV file. Choose Add and Save Configuration. Having added the evaluation dataset, return to the playground. Look for the option that says Configure Aggregation. I'd like to request the average latency and the average Rouge 1. From the dropdown, select the evaluation dataset you just added. Then click Generate Metrics. The pop-up notification tells me that the job has been queued. Be patient while the job runs. The metrics will appear as they complete, along with additional pop-up notifications. At this point, I have two that are complete and one that's still pending. For the two that are complete, the Rouge 1 average is very similar. We can also compare the latency, 9.27 or 4.4. To be clear, these aggregate metrics are based on the rows in the evaluation dataset. To see the row-level details behind any of these, click Configure. On the left-hand side, look for the chat named Aggregated Chat. This will contain all the responses to the prompts in the evaluation dataset. Here are some more fun conference talks. What have we learned from ISS telescopes? And how are LIKEN liking space? As a user, you can provide thumbs up positive feedback or thumbs down negative feedback on each of these generations. Then, from the icon labeled Tracing, you can access a table of all the LLM blueprint responses so far. This table traces exactly which LLM parameters, which vector database, which system prompt, and which user prompt resulted in a particular generated response. On the far right-hand side, you'll see the user feedback, which can be used for LLM fine-tuning. Here we can see the two pieces of feedback I just provided. The tracing table can be added to the DataRobot AI catalog, and from there you have many options, such as writing it to a database table on a schedule or downloading it. That concludes the space research walkthrough. Returning to the use case folder, all the assets are well organized and shareable. The original dataset, the two vector databases, and the playground that contains all the experimentation. I'll end by giving my playground a more descriptive name, such as conference pitches. Please take a moment to rate the quality of this learning content, and happy experimenting.